हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज रवि फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सल पब्लिक स्कूल औराद शाहजनी। वी हैड डिस्कस्ड डेफिनेशन ऑफ पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच, देन डेफिनेशन ऑफ नाउन एंड इट्स टाइप्स, प्रोनाउन एंड इट्स टाइप्स, एडजेक्टिव्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स, आर्टिकल्स एंड देयर यूजेस। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, बट वन थिंग I would like to mention for all the parents and all the students, whatever videos are uploaded, nobody asked a single doubt. So all the students are requested to send your doubts on WhatsApp group, or else you can simply mention in the comments. Because friends, unless you ask doubts, I am unable to solve them. So please ask your doubts and get the solution immediately. We are going to start very interesting topic, the next parts of speech, that is verb. Friends, it is said that verbs are soul of English language. They play very important role for the formation of sentences. Yes, it is true. Friends, first we will discuss exactly the definition of verb. Let's start then. I have written on the board, very simple example, very simple sentence I have written on the board. Action words are called verbs. Enough. Definition of verb is what? Action words are called verbs. The words which express action are called verbs. Nothing else. For example, clap, run, stand, look, write, read. There are many examples. These are action words. Why they are called action words? Because they express action. Action of a human being, action of a person. And that is only called in the language of grammar, verb. So friends, let's start with the types of verb. How the verbs are used in the sentences in correct manner. What are the errors while using verbs? Let's start then. See friends, verbs are divided into two main types, main verb and helping verb. Helping verbs are also called auxiliary verbs. There are two types of verbs, main verb and helping verb. Let's start with the main verb. Again, this concept of main verb, it has two types. First one, that is regular verbs and irregular verbs. Why they are called regular and irregular? Let me explain through some examples. See friends, I have written three examples. We know everyone, verb first form, second form, third form and ing form of verb. That is clear. Everybody knows it. regular verbs are always, the second and third forms are always with ed or d suffix. For example, first form want, second wanted, third wanted. Laugh, laughed, laughed. Like, liked, liked. T, t, t. Sometimes t sound, it should be there, and sometimes d sound. Wanted, wanted, wanted. Laughed, laughed, laughed. Liked, liked, liked. Like this. Is this clear? They are with d or ed suffix. That's why they are called regular verbs. Let's discuss about irregular verbs and their forms. So friends, first form, second form, third form I have written. Let's study. Sit, sat, sat. Come, came, come. Go, went, gone. Hit, hit, hit. These verbs are called irregular verbs because sometimes their second and third forms are same. Sometimes their first and third forms are same. Some verbs are there, their all three forms are different. Some are there, their all three forms are same. As in examples you can find out. Hit, hit, hit. Three forms same. Go, went, gone. Three forms different. Come, came, come. First form and third form are same. Sit, sat, sat. Second and third forms are same. That's why they are called irregular verbs. Regular and irregular, both of them are called main verbs. You should keep in your mind. For our study and easily, we should recite them. That's why they are divided in regular and irregular forms. While reciting regular verbs, if you learn only first form, and simply we can add ed, d suffix, regular verbs. But for irregular verbs, we have to learn, recite all three forms. The reason, recently I have told you. Is this clear? Yes. Let's move towards next. Some main verbs are divided into these two types also: stative verbs and action verbs. Friends, this should be known because most of the time we have to use different tenses for formation of sentences. Whenever we use stative verbs, we are not supposed to use them in continuous tenses. We are not allowed to use stative verbs in continuous tenses. Means what? With ing form, we can't use stative verbs. Now, what is the exactly meaning of stative verbs? Stative verbs means what? The verbs which express only situation. And action verbs, the verbs which express physical activity. This is the basic difference between stative and action verbs. Stative verbs express only situation. Action verbs express physical activity. For example, stative verbs, example, understand, hate, love, etc. Understand, hate, love, these verbs are expressing only situation. There is no any physical activity. Is this clear? For example, action words: run, sleep, read, etc. Is this clear? Read, action of reading, expressing. Run, action of running. Sleep, action of sleeping. That's why they are called action verbs. Stative verbs, understand, hate, love, think, they are only expressing situations. For example, we'll study them with some examples. Students, understand the concept. One more example I will give you. First example, students understand the concept. Second example, students run on the ground. In first examples, we are getting some kind of information. That is, understand, that is only the situation, that is, there is no any physical activity, but students run on the ground, there is a physical activity of running. This is the difference. So friends, whenever you find such kind of stative verbs, so you are not supposed to use them in continuous tenses. What I'm telling, stative verbs should not be used with ing form. Students are understanding, absolutely wrong. He is wanting chocolates. How does it seem? Very wrong. So stative verbs always should be used first form, second form, third form. No ing form. Action verbs, we can use them in continuous tenses. Is this clear? Good. So friends, we should know exactly transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. We should know transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. So transitive verbs means what? If we ask question with the help of what, then we get answer of a particular noun or pronoun. What gives us answer of an object? Means whenever we use transitive verb in a sentence, that time object is compulsory, that is must. For example, if I write only this, he kicked, but what? He kicked a ball. The ball is an object. If I ask question with the help of what, then I will get answer of object. Is this clear? This is called transitive verb. And intransitive verbs, they don't need object to complete the meaning and sense. For example, a man laughs loudly. For example, a man laughs loudly. Here, main verb is there, but no object. This is called an adverb. In next session, we are going to discuss about adverb. So, transitive verbs always are with an object. Intransitive verbs are not with an object. They don't need object. Is this clear? Good. This was all about main verbs. Once again, I will revise it. Main verbs are divided into regular and irregular verbs as per their forms first form, second form, third form. Then we discussed about stative verbs which express only action, sorry, stative verbs, they express only situation. After that, action words, they express physical activity. Transitive verbs are with object. Intransitive verb don't need an object. Clear? Then we'll move towards next type of verb that is very important, helping verbs, and which are called auxiliary verbs also. See friends, these helping verbs, which are called auxiliary verbs, they are divided into two types. First one, that is primary auxiliaries, and second one, that is called modal auxiliaries, modals. Modals, in a separate session we are going to discuss about modal auxiliaries. Can, may, might, shall, should, these are called modal auxiliaries. We need separate session for them. We are going to discuss about primary auxiliaries. Primary auxiliaries, they have three types. There are only three types of primary auxiliaries. First one, to be. Second one, to do. And third one, to have. What I'm telling, primary auxiliary verbs are divided into three types. They have three types: to be forms, to have forms, to do forms. There are only three tenses in English. The main tenses, don't be confused: present, past, and future. As per these three tenses, to be, to do, and to have forms are divided. Let's start with the to be forms. To be forms are, I had already explained, in present, am, is, are. In past, was, were, were, were. Future, will be. Many students, they have confusion yet about shall. Friends, for your kind information, CPSE pattern has removed using shall. So in place of shall, simply we can use will. Once again I will revise. To be forms: present, am, is, are; past, was, were; future, will be. To do forms, same: present, do, does; past, did; future, will do. To have forms: present, have, has; past, had; future, will have. Friends, to be forms are used in continuous tenses: present continuous, past continuous, and future continuous. For example, children are playing, are present continuous. In present continuous, we have to use am, is, are. Past continuous, was, were. And in future continuous, will be. I will be delivering session on adverbs. I was explaining types of adjectives, past continuous. I am explaining verbs, present continuous. Same, do, does are used in simple present. Did is used in simple past. Will do, do is not used. Only will is used, it is considered in simple future. For the formation of negative sentences and asking questions. To have forms. To have forms, they have different use. But as far as tenses are concerned, to have forms are used in perfect and perfect continuous tenses. Have, has are used in present perfect. Had in past perfect. will have in future perfect. And in perfect continuous tenses, present perfect continuous have has been been with ing form. Had been ing, past perfect continuous. And will have been ing, future perfect continuous tense. So friends, this was all about verbs and its types. If you have any doubts, then please mention in the comments. And due to some technical errors, there are some interruption, some distractions in today's video. I apologize. I extremely felt very sorry for that, and I apologize for it. If you have any doubt, then please mention in the comments, or else you can simply send on the WhatsApp group. Meanwhile, for a day, we'll stop here. Please stay home, stay safe. Thank you.